So, if you're anything like me, you probably get called upon quite often to help your family and friends with tech support on their iPhones and iPads. There's always that really tricky conversation on the phone. No, not that button. No, not that one. Yes, that one there. Well, an amazing new feature built into FaceTime on iOS 15.1 will make those phone calls a thing of the past. Now you can share your screen between devices. Here's how it works. Once again, you join me on another FaceTime call with myself. Yes, I do have my own friends, but believe it or not, it's much easier to record a FaceTime call between myself for this video. Now, unfortunately, Jacob on the iPhone has a problem with his phone and wants to share his screen with Jacob on the iPad to get some advice from him. I know it's a bit convoluted, but trust me, it's a good demo. So on my iPhone, I'm going to tap on my screen in the FaceTime call to get that new menu bar at the top of my screen. And then on the right-hand side, I'm going to press the Share Screen button. At this point, the iPad will start seeing a blurred version of my iPhone screen. Now, it's blurred because I'm still in that FaceTime call, but as soon as I swipe up out of FaceTime to my home screen, that will then be shown in full quality on the iPad as well. Of course, this works on more than just two devices, it would work in a group FaceTime as well. Now, on the iPad, I've now got the iPhone's home screen floating as what's called a picture-in-picture window. I can move this around my screen, I can even leave FaceTime and go somewhere else, and that window will still be floating. I can resize it by pinching and zooming, and I can position it wherever I like. But I actually want to go back into FaceTime, so I'm going to switch up into multitasking mode and tap onto that conversation I've got active already. Now from here, I can tap on the screen share to make it fill my iPad screen. At this point, I can see really clearly what's on the iPhone screen, and I can instruct Jacob to solve his problem by going into settings, I can recommend some cool apps to go for in the App Store, and I can talk him through this as I'm seeing what he's doing. Of course, I can also recommend a really cool YouTube channel, which he may or may not have heard of, but if you're watching this and you haven't yet subscribed, please do, you'll be cool like us then. And at this point, I think I've fixed all of Jacob's problems on his iPhone, so he can now go ahead and stop that screen share. I'm going to do this by tapping the little screen share indicator in the top left of my screen, and then pressing the end button to stop that share. As soon as that screen share ends, the iPad will go back to its normal home screen, and on my iPhone I can swipe up to multitasking mode to jump back into my open FaceTime conversation. I'll do that on the iPad as well, just to close this out quite nicely, and that's a really quick demo of how you can share your screen between devices. And of course, this works in any combination of devices as well. You can share your screen from an iPad to an iPhone or another iPad, iPhone to iPhone, even in group chats. It works exactly the same, no matter what you're doing. I really hope you found this useful. If you have, please do subscribe down below and give the video a like. And there are loads more videos on iOS 15 waiting for you on my YouTube channel. I'll see you all next time.